Have you ever watched a presentation and been blown away by how good the slides looked? Like they were meant to go together, supporting everything the presenter said. In this lesson, we're going to look at how to get text and imagery into your presentation, but more importantly, we're going to show you how to make them look consistent, like one big happy family. How many presentations have you seen without any text? It's probably pretty rare. Text is a very important part of a presentation. Let's learn how to add text to your presentation. We have two ways to add text in Canva. We can add a text box by pressing the T key on the keyboard, or simply go to the text menu on the left object panel. Here, you'll have three text options: heading, subheading, and body text. One of the most important techniques for effectively communicating content is the use of typographic hierarchy. This helps you present your content in a way that visually conveys to the audience where to look and in what sequence. There are four parts in the text hierarchy you need to know about. Headings are short phrases that indicate what the next section of your slide is all about. They serve as a preview to the audience, but also as a divider between the previous information and the next. They are often bold and have a lot of personality. Therefore, you're best to use them in small doses. Subheadings further refine the big ideas you identify in headings. They reveal a little more to your audience about what you are going to talk about. Body copy makes your work meaningful by explaining the heading and the subhead. Here, you add your written content. Now, in a presentation, you don't want to use too much body copy. Remember, the audience is here to hear you speak, not read your slides. Of course, if you're not going to be there to present the slides, then you might think about having a little more body copy. But generally, always remember, the presentation slides are there to add visual weight to what you're saying, not do the talking for you. Finally, we have captions. These are small titles or brief explanations that accompany illustrations or imagery. They might be there to explain the picture or advise where you got the image from. Now for the interesting part, the images. There are multiple methods to add images into your presentation. If you don't have a specific photo you want to use, click on the Photos menu in the left object panel and search for images related to the topic. Try not to choose an image that exactly mimics what you are saying with text or verbally. You want your imagery to tell more of the story, not just mirror it. If photos are going to be too prescriptive, maybe try illustrations. Go to the Elements menu and click on Graphics. There are thousands of options to choose from. If you have something specific in mind, type it in the search field, selecting Graphics. Once you choose something, Canva creates magic recommendations. This way you can see other graphics or photos that are similar to what you chose. This is really handy if you want a few different things, but with the same style. You could also select an image or illustration from your previous uploads. Select Uploads in the left object panel, then Images, and grab the image you want. Of course, you could always drag and drop. Click and drag the image from your desktop and drop it into your presentation. Adjust your image in the slide accordingly. Great, it's looking good. We've added text and images to our presentation, and they look good, but they don't look like they really go together. What we could do is use some effects to give them a consistent look. Start by selecting an image. You'll see the top menu change to give you options for adjusting the image. The Adjust button will allow you to take control of the brightness and contrast, the saturation and the tint. Go ahead and play with the sliders. Don't forget to use the Reset button if you don't like it. If you do like it, just copy the filter code at the bottom left and add that to your other photos. Filter gives you some pre-selected adjustments, an easy way to quickly bring about some consistency. This image menu will also allow you to crop your photos or flip it. Another way you can create consistency in your presentation is through your color palette. Choosing a similar background color will pull the presentation together and show the audience that these slides belong together. If you click on the background, you'll see an option to choose a color. Canva will offer you some default colors, but if you have an image on your slide, it will also develop a color palette based on the colors found in the image. This is an easy way to bring consistency to your presentation very quickly. we suggest not using more than 5 colors in your color palette. Apply the colors to your text, and suddenly you have a presentation that really grabs attention. Practice hierarchy and consistency in your presentations, and your slides will look more impactful and ultimately communicate better to your audience.